With Kansas City considering a downtown streetcar line, a lot of people are seeing a mass transit commercial on TV. So is it a campaign ad or is it something else? KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney is live now to explain.
Well, Kelly, it's both. Some downtowners pretty soon expect to vote on a tax plan to help fund part of a $100 million 2-mile streetcar line that would run from the River Market down to about Union Station. And even though it's not going to be a citywide vote, this commercial's on the air and some people are seeing this.
Imagine taking a train to the game.
Or riding streetcars around town.
This is a commercial aimed at getting people to think differently about forms of mass transit, including commuter trains from the suburbs, something far beyond the Metro's bus system. And advocates think that people in car-happy Kansas City are changing their minds.
I don't think in the near future, you know, a lot of people are going to be dependent on their car.
Streetcar advocates all over America point to Portland, where the city spent $55 million for a successful streetcar line. But that was accompanied by another $500 million in redevelopment subsidies along that route. Now, it did work, but a streetcar critic, Randall O'Toole of the libertarian Cato think tank, says it wasn't just because of the streetcars.
So the $55 million streetcar line did not generate that new development. It was a $500 million in subsidies that generated the development. But they never mentioned this.
Some streetcar advocates acknowledge that just replacing bus fleets with something else doesn't always work. And some cities have streetcar lines that struggle. It takes other money. Now, the Kansas City line would cost $100 million just by itself. So this is expensive.
What's not expensive these days? Food's going up, fuel going up. Everything's expensive, you know it.
Now, the streetcar advocates here in Kansas City are still working on the details of this plan and perhaps a vote a little bit later on. So ladies from downtown, back to you.
Thanks, Michael. Now, those streetcar advocates are trying to establish a governing board for the line, and they may take a streetcar tax plan to downtown voters as early as November.